Kids or something crazy?
I can't even remember now. I lost the number in my head. A bunch.
But coming back, you got a lot of players filling a lot of gaps. How do you feel about the team so early into the offseason?
They're doing everything that we ask them to do. We're doing everything. We're busting ourselves in the morning in the weight room. They're coming, they're getting a little bit of a break, getting hydrated, eating something, coming back in the afternoon for our meetings and practice. We're about 71 right now, 9 through 12. And I couldn't be happier with what I'm getting. I mean, we have standards that are set. The standard is the standard. And we don't change for anybody or anything. And they're doing a great job of following the blueprint that we've had for success the last 2 years. We're young and inexperienced. That's going to happen when you graduate what we did. But these guys are going to be all right. They're going to be a good football team, but it's going to take some time, but we're going to get there.
And how do you feel about, I lost my train of thought. I'm sorry. But how do you feel coming back? Well, what is the schedule going on for this week? I heard something about Higginsville. What's going on there?
And Friday and Saturday will be at Higginsville's contact camp. It's just control scrimmages versus whoever's there.
Okay. And, having your players get some actual physical time on the field, how important is that to establish, especially this early on?
Hey, everything, any amount of reps that we can get is important, whether it be camp or a team camp. We go down there, whether it be here or someplace else. But when you get a rep against somebody else, the guys get a little bit more excited, it gets a little bit more physical, and it gives us a good idea where we're at and what we need to do to get better.
And I finally found my train of thought, which is last year, of course, COVID hit. It was start and stop. You just couldn't get any momentum going. But this year, that doesn't seem to be a big issue anymore. How do you think that's going to kind of change you guys, considering strength and conditioning is one of the top priorities for you each offseason?
Well, we got very fortunate last year to have the group that we did. They were primed and ready to go, and the weights and stuff that we missed wasn't so big. It would be a big deal this year if COVID had hit this year, not last. I mean, these guys need every second they can get in that weight room and developing speed and agility like we're trying to do on the field. I'm just very happy that we're able to do those things with these guys. High school football is about development. It's scheme development, it's muscular development, it's speed and agility development. It's about developing kids when you get them. And we're right in the middle of that right now. And the key thing is they got to be here. You know, you got to be here with a great attitude and give the best effort that you can. If you do that, we can develop you.
And one more question, which is, how do you feel about these kids' enthusiasm for the team? Of course, coming off, I think it was 7-4 last year, I think 8-4. That's a lot of momentum to carry over. Tell me a little bit about how enthusiastic these kids are right now.
Well, they're in there. In pre-practice or in before practice for our team meetings, singing country songs. So I think they're pretty excited about what's going on. They're hooting and hollering in the morning when they get up, and we're going through, you know, just sweating to death out here, and we're pressing and running sprints, and they're screaming and yelling at each other in a positive manner. So, you know, their enthusiasm has been contagious with us as a staff. These guys are fun. Young kids that have the right attitude, the right frame of mind are fun to be around, because almost everything you do is new and they learn something new every day. When you see the light bulb go off in their eyes, that's pretty cool.
All right. No, that's all I got. No COVID holding you back. I mean, a full camp. Of course, a few guys are missing because of graduation, but lots of players coming back. How do you guys feel right now?
Oh, we feel great. I mean, we're out here busting our butts every day, getting 1% better. We got new freshmen coming in that got killer athletes. I mean, we're just grinding out here. We're just going to get better every day, ready for this camp next weekend.
What do you think? We were talking a little bit about this team on the sideline. How do you feel about this year?
I feel like it's going to be a lot better than what everybody thinks. And I think that we can be just as good, if not better, than last year.
And Cole?
Everybody showing up to weights every day, and everybody's putting in their 1%. So I think that we could be a good football team.
Speaking of weights, I was just about to ask that. You're looking a lot bigger, a lot meaner. What's going on here?
Mike Clayton said I'm just, you know, going to weights, keeping myself accountable, pushing my other teammates, and hoping that – you know, if everybody pushes themselves, we're all push each other to be better, and, you know, we'll be better than what everybody's expecting us to be.
And how do you feel about the line right now? Sometimes that's just the glue that brings it all together, and you guys trying to work some guys out in some different spots. What's going on there, both offensive line and defensive line?
I feel pretty confident in our offensive line this year. You know, we lost Cam, Wyatt, and Keegan, and Preston, and those were pretty big guys for us. But me, Caleb, Rick, Wyatt, Reed, Remy, you know, we've all been playing since our 7th and 8th grade year together, and so we all have pretty good chemistry together, and so we're all excited, and we got Jonathan back this year, so we're really excited to have him back.
And who's Jonathan?
Jonathan Reichard.
Okay. And, you know, you're also the back feels a lot different this year, but how do you feel about the young guys coming in and filling those roles?
I mean, I'm going to miss the older guys, of course, but I mean, I got trust with these guys. We got good chemistry. We've been working together for a while now. Hopefully we can just get it done.
And you're a senior this year. You know, they talk about you sometimes my years get mixed up. I'm 99% sure, but yeah. You know, sometimes you're trying to leave your mark. What are you trying to leave for this team, especially being a running back, you know, being, I think it's three, almost 4 year starter.
I'm just trying to leave that I gave everything I ever had every time I was on the field, whether it was running the ball on defense, helping younger guys. I just wanted to give them all the time.
And now for all three of you guys, there's a lot of young guys out here. A lot of young guys are going to have to fill some holes. How do you feel about being an upperclassman and kind of being that guide for them, especially when you're trying to build that, continue building on that foundation that was started a few years ago?
I mean, it's pretty weird being the older guy now, but I mean, we're getting pretty used to it. But yeah, some of the younger guys are pretty good. We just got to help them out.
What do you think?
I think that any of these young guys are capable to come up and fill any of the roles that they're asked to. I mean, all we have to do is just give a little bit of a helping hand and tell them what they need to do. Tell them, be coach's voice for them.
And last question goes to you. What do you think?
I mean, basically what Dom and Clayton said, you know, we just got to be that role model and we really got to set an example. Sometimes the best leaders, you know, they show by example rather than using their voice. And that's really what I want to leave my mark as is, you know, somebody who set an example as, you know, not necessarily a vocal leader, but somebody that really showed people how to do it without talking.
All right. Well, no, that's all I got. Hey, I appreciate you guys.